could have ever prepared me for what it's like to experience heartbreak, and the type of heartbreak where you fully let it consume you, and it's a life turning point. Depression took over me and I lost every shred of light that I had left. I fell into a state where I felt like there was no return. I got to the point where I had this dark cloud following me everywhere I went, and so dark that my thoughts wandered to wanting to let go of life. I was living, but I wasn't alive. Losing someone who had become a part of me, momentarily pulling me away from that side of myself. Someone who had become my distraction, not only from all the bad things in my life, but from myself. I lost that sense of stability that I allowed myself to put on that one person. It's not fair to expect someone else to be your source of happiness. At the end of the day, the only stability you truly have is yourself. And I know I don't ever want to go back to that dark place again. Myself. I don't remember a time where I wasn't tearing myself apart because I didn't feel like I was good enough or worthy of love. As time passes by, I find myself fading deeper and deeper away into the endless abyss of my mind. I want to know what it's like to genuinely receive and accept pure love. I give so much love away when I don't have any for myself. I give so much that I forget to take a step back and really feel what it is to be loved. I've never known a time where I wasn't morphing myself into the perception of others. Maybe just being myself is enough. Maybe it's okay not to be okay right now. If you live to please everyone else, you find yourself burning in the depths of your own mind. It's the simple moments in life that I yearn for. The simple moments that bring me so much bliss and will pass me by in an instant if I don't slow down and appreciate them. I want to learn to live fully for myself and not live to satisfy others.
And so today, after having a release yesterday, I went to this beach and I sat by a tree and I looked out into the ocean and I sat down and I put on some music and I journaled and I cried for hours and hours just sitting there looking out, thinking of every single heartbreak from my family, from myself, from other people that I've endured my entire life, and knowing that I let myself slip into a deep depression, knowing that I wanted to let go of my life, feeling like there was no hope. I sat there and I released it all. And I reflected on my past decisions, my past encounters, my past thoughts. And I just let it go for me. I probably looked crazy. There were probably people who passed by me and were like, damn, she's going through it. Because I was sitting there like this with my head down, but then also looking around. And then there was a point where I was laying down and I was looking up and I was listening to music and I was crying and crying and crying. And sometimes it's okay. You need that. You need to just drown yourself out from the world and really focus on your thoughts and reflect. And so I sat there and I let things go. And I said to myself, you know, whatever happens, happens. It is what it is. And life is exactly how it's supposed to be. There are times where you will feel like you have no control. There will be times where you feel like everything around you is against you. But the truth is that you are the only one who can control yourself, your thoughts, your actions, the people that you surround yourself with, the encounters that you have day to day, because it all comes down to your reaction and how that affects your mind. Yes, there are times where I'm emotionally driven and I let my emotions and my thoughts take over me, and I think about small encounters and it consumes me, and I don't want to be consumed or feel like I have no control, because in reality, I'm not my thoughts. They don't have to control me. I'm the observer of my thoughts. I can sit there and be like, I'm thinking this, but I don't have to let it emotionally affect me. And that's what I'm trying to achieve. I'm trying to get better at doing that, because I just feel so sensitive. But now, I got up out of my slump. I went to class. And I'm trying to get to a place that I want to be. I want to live the life that I desire in any way possible, achieve the goals that I've set for myself, finally stop making excuses. Everyone makes so many excuses for why they're not achieving the things that they want. And that's because how can you achieve something if you don't put any action towards it? And I've been wasting my time sitting there in my bed and dwelling on life, dwelling, like feeling like I'm a victim of my own life. And I'm tired of feeling like that. I'm tired of feeling consumed by my thoughts, by my emotions, by how others affect me. I don't want that for myself. So I'm gonna put on my headphones and I'm gonna get into the groove of cleaning and starting wherever I can to be the person that I've always dreamed of. I want to be a person that I look up to. I want to make my younger self proud, because I look back at photos of myself as a child and I had so many dreams and so many desires, and I didn't care about what anyone thought. I never remember having myself be so consumed by what other people think of me. And I don't want to feel like that. I just want to embrace life, and kids are so happy. I want to channel that part of myself and see the beauty in life and just be present and live in every second and protect myself. Because I want to be someone that my 7-year-old self can look up to and be proud. That's all I want. So that's what I'm trying to achieve. One step at a time. One thing at a time. I don't want to do too many things to where I feel overwhelmed. one thing at a time and know that at least I'm taking the steps. I'm not making excuses for myself anymore. I'm living life for me, not for anyone else anymore. Because at the end of the day, all you have is yourself. All you have is your own thoughts. At the end of the night, when you go to sleep, that's all you have. And you can either choose to wake up every day and dwell in the past days, or you can live every day like it's a brand new life. Like all that other baggage and bullshit that happened is non-existent. And move forward, keep your head present and forward. That's what I want to do. And that's what I'm going to do. Because it took me getting to rock bottom and hating myself and hating everything about my life. But it just takes a shift in perspective, reflection, and feeling pure pain and knowing that you never want to feel like that again. I never want to feel like that again.
Growing up in chaos has made me not know how to live in peace. So as I begin this journey of self-love, I know that there's gonna be so many days where the weights of the past weigh me down. But all I could hope for is that I continue to prevail and keep moving forward and not go back to the destructive mindset of feeling so overwhelmed that I want to let go of life. I want to create beauty. I want to create serenity. I want to just feel happy. I want to feel completely, irrevocably in love with myself, because I've never felt that before.
But I want to try.